Hi everyone, and welcome to Storytime. Today, I'm going to share with you the best definition of reliability-centered maintenance that I have ever heard. It has shaped the way I've thought about RCM over the years and the way that I teach it. I started doing RCM over 26 years ago when I was a civilian employee of the United States Navy. I was working at the Naval Air Warfare Center in Lakehurst, New Jersey, and we were applying RCM to aviation ground support equipment, things like aircraft tow tractors, mobile electric power plants, mobile air conditioning units, and crash cranes. At that time, I was lucky enough to be able to collaborate with members of the British Royal Navy's RCM program. And one night in Bath, England, when we were having a team dinner, I was sitting across from Commander Andrew Mattis. He was the head of the Royal Navy's RCM program at the time. And I'll never forget this. He leaned in and he put his elbows on the table and he looked at me and he said, "You know, Nancy, reliability-centered maintenance is nothing more than common sense applied to physical assets." Well, that moment has stuck with me even after all these years. RCM really is common sense applied to physical assets. We're not splitting the atom when we do RCM. RCM teaches us how to identify safe and cost-effective proactive maintenance tasks and their associated intervals. It helps us to determine how we should take care of our safety systems, our protective devices, to make sure that they're available to us in the event that something else goes wrong. And it helps us to figure out how to manage those failure modes where proactive maintenance isn't a viable solution. And maybe most importantly, reliability-centered maintenance helps to unite our entire reliability team, setting the foundation for an effective reliability culture. When RCM is done correctly with the right people, it can transform an organization. I've seen it firsthand. The RCM program that I started when I was a Navy employee on ground support equipment is still going strong today, 26 years later. It is a testament to the strength of reliability-centered maintenance and the commitment to the people within that organization to reliability. Reliability-centered maintenance isn't a quick fix. It's not a silver bullet for your reliability. But there's a reason why it stole my technical heart and soul over 26 years ago. And that is because over a period of time, you will start to see your reliability improve and you'll start to see your teams come together. So what's stopping you from doing a couple of pilot projects on reliability-centered maintenance? Why not take it out for a spin and see what it can do for your reliability and your organization as a whole? I'm Nancy Regan. Thank you for watching.